Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make a shiny metallic text effect in Adobe Illustrator. This is a question that came up in our Illustrator Facebook group, and I want to give a shout out to Steve Fatone, who showed the steps on how to do this. I also want to mention that it's free to join the Illustrator Facebook group, and there will be a link below in the description. Just please don't spam us or we'll kick you right out. All right, let's get started. Okay, so this is the text we're going to make. So first I'm going to hit T to get on my text tool, and I'll just click once on the screen. I already have my font in here, TT Travels Next, and this is an Adobe font. So if you have Creative Cloud, it'll be available to you. I'll type shiny, and then they need to be on separate type paths. So I'm going to get off of this, and then I'll hold Shift and Option or Shift and Alt to make a copy, and I'll type text over here. So first I'm going to focus on shiny. I'll click on that, and then I'll need my appearance panel up. So I'll go to Window, Appearance, and then I need to get my fill out of characters and into type. So I'll double click characters, I'll click the fill, and then I'll delete it. Then I'll go up to this little hamburger menu and choose Add New Fill. We're going to have two fills on this, and they'll both be gradients. So I'm going to get on my gradient tool over here, and I'll also get on my gradient tool here, and I'll click this gradient slider. And this is probably what it'll look like for you, but if it doesn't, just come up here to this and choose white black, so yours will look like mine. Now I want this to go from top to bottom, so I'll type in 90 here. And now it's the opposite, so I'm gonna flip it. I'll reverse the gradient with this button. I'll double click the left side node, and I'm going to put the black at 20%. I'll hold Option or Alt and click and drag and put it about right here. And I'll double click this one and put the black at 40. And then finally, this last one will also be 20. Now I'm going to move this node so it comes up a little closer over here until we're seeing a little more definition in the gradient right here. I'll bring this other one down a little bit. And I think this looks pretty nice. Maybe we can move these down just a little bit more. So that is the back layer. And if we zoom in here, you can see it right here. It goes all the way out and around like this. Now we'll work on the other fill, which is this gradient here. So with this still selected, I'll click and drag my fill onto this little plus button down here. And that'll give me a copy, one right on top of the other. For this top copy, I'm going to move my leftmost node, not all the way to the end, but right about here. And then I'll move this one about halfway. I'll double click on this one, and I'm going to put that at 100%. And then finally, I'm going to move this far right slider as close as I can get to the other one. And that gives us a nice hard line right here. And then with that node selected, I'm going to decrease my opacity to 0. So now this section, or the top half, is transparent, and so we can see what's underneath here. Finally, the last step here is to offset path. So I'll go to Effect, Path, and Offset Path. And we need this to be a negative number so that it kind of squeezes in. I'll put it at -1 and see how that looks. Maybe even -1.5. Okay, and this looks good. So we pretty much got almost exactly the same thing. And yours might look a little bit different, but hopefully you have something similar. Okay, so we've got that first part done. Now with this selected, I'm going to come back to my appearance panel and I'll click and drag right on the little image next to type. Click and drag that into my graphic styles. Now I can click on text and choose that graphic style and it will be applied to that too. This will make it easy to change to this style. So with text selected, I'll get on my lower fill and I'll come back to my gradient. I'll choose Edit Gradient. And now I can click these nodes and apply different colors to them. So to get that kind of teal color, you can kind of play around with these sliders. I'm liking 47, 0, 9, and 6 for my CMYK values. Now I'll hold Option or Alt to make a copy, and I'm going to put it somewhere over by the other one. I'll click and drag and pull that one off and move this one over. Then I'll click and drag this one off too. I'll hold Option and make a third copy here. It's just easier to do it that way because of the color. And now I'm just going to increase the black on that and the cyan. maybe a bit of green. Okay, so this is looking pretty good up here, a little bit different, but that's okay. Now I'll click on the other fill, which is on top, and I'm gonna go ahead and make a new color group from this text so that I can get the colors into my swatches. I'll choose new color group, which is this little button right over here on my swatches panel. And now we have those. So I'll double click this, I'll choose my swatches, then I'll choose this darker one, but I'm gonna come back up here to color and add a lot of black. I don't want it to be black, but I wanna add a lot of black to the blue just to keep it in the same kind of color range. Then next I'll click on this gray one over here and I'll make that the lighter blue. Okay, and that's pretty much it. It's not exactly the same, but you can really make your colors anything you want. And then of course with this one, you could also make a graphic style by taking this little picture right up here and dragging it down there. And that way you can apply it to anything. And that's it. All right, I hope this video was helpful. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.